Hi guys, I'm Kamiya Jani. You probably know of me as a lady who travels around the world. I am the founder and chief traveling officer at Curly Tails. And here's what I was up to before I started this.
Hi there, good morning. Well, it's a brand new week and a brand new edition of Morning Mantra on ET Now. I'm Kamiya Varma.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Megha.
I was a business news anchor. I would probably be surprising a lot of my school and college friends if they see me thinking that, oh, she's the quiet girl who we never expected anything out of. I never took part in any debates or, you know, elocution or anything that's remotely close to public speaking.
Hello, I'm Kamiya, a lifestyle expert, an adventure junkie and a travel enthusiast.
I was that quiet person who would never draw attention to myself, even be uncomfortable if there was even the slightest of attention towards me.
So when we started Curly Tails, which was about 2.5 years ago, it started off as my personal page where I would write about my experiences. And given the television background I had, I thought, how about I make videos?
Well, you will also hear some Punjabi music playing on the streets of South.
I would walk around different places, and that's how I used to do it. There's no professional equipment that I had, just talking to my mobile phone.
There you don't have to really bargain.
Again, I didn't have to buy the phone. I reached out to the Apple brand and I said, if you like my work, and I could give you credits. And then Apple was kind enough to give me that phone.
Hi there, wish you all a very, very happy new year. This time from a country I never thought I would visit, Sri Lanka.
I mean, I think everybody has a different definition of rich, but I'm very calculative when it comes to my expenses. I don't spend my money on travels. I charge to travel. I don't travel for free anymore. It's the other way around.
Destinations, but what makes it even better is go as direct flight.
Also, it's a lot of hard work. You know, it's a responsibility from my end to be able to do justice and the trust that the tourism board or a hotel or any other brand has put into us. We are literally on our feet for a good 14 to 16 hours. We only come back to our room when we know that there's literally no scope for shooting anything else. For a lot of our viewers, traveling is all about fun. But to be honest, at Curly Tails, traveling requires a lot of effort and discipline.
Kamiya, you always forget to give the link on this camera.
The whole process begins once we discover something that's unique. We have a tentative script in our mind, but we don't write anything because we want to go and find out what that thing is all about. I would reach there, I would shoot the entire place, and I would say whatever comes to my mind as my first impression of being at that place. Hi, this time I've landed myself on an island I know nothing about. I would come back, sit with the editor, just saying, you know, the most unique thing has to come up first, which should attract the attention of our viewers.
Well, this is called the James Bond Island, and it gets its name from a film that was shot here in 1974.
Initially, we started doing 1 to 1.5 minute long videos. Just on the edit table, it would take about 3 to 4 hours.
Well, this is one of India's best infinity pools.
Now it's more about, you know, long form content, which goes from 7 minutes to 9 minutes. There's a huge build up of an anchor reaching a destination, what she thinks. It's a lot more elaborate now, and every video as of today takes about 2 days to edit. It is work at the end of the day. You know, for people, for everyone else, it may appear as travel, but for me, who's involved in it, it's work. When you are collaborating with a brand and they do have certain expectations, so you may have to live up to it whether sometimes you like it or not. In Johannesburg, the tourism board booked this experience for bungee jump. I didn't want to do it. It's like committing suicide. Aap terrace par jao aur aise rakkar bas free fall karo, look at the ground. So the South African guy, he's like, come on, jump. And then I decided to just close my eyes and do it. So I go to the back office and I'm like, hi, can I see the footage? They're like, what's your number? And then I give them my number. And then they go through their video files and they're seeing it. And they're like, oh, sorry, you know what? There was a glitch and we couldn't record it. I'm like, what? I just went through so much and you didn't record it?
It was challenging. It's a lot of work, a lot of discipline, and not as hunky-dory as you would see it in the videos. I love traveling. I just think it's such an enriching experience. It's so beautiful to be out there. You realize that you're just like a spot on this entire world. So many times you come across people you meet, destinations you visit, which you've not even thought of.
Hi there, you're watching Midcap Mantra with Ashudath, and we have two guests, Devang Masaria and Ashit Suri.
So a lot of people have misconception about me, about where I come from or how easy life is for me. But I've also had to go through my share of struggles to get to where I am today. It took me 5 years to actually become a news anchor from the time I passed out of college. When I thought that it would be very easy, but I had to do a lot of odd jobs, different things to have that dream of mine to materialize.
No, nothing specific, Kamiya. I'm just looking at the fact
I started off my journey as a personal finance writer at CNBC. I think after completing a year, I reached out to my boss. She was of the idea that I'm not good enough to be in front of the camera. And I get what she was saying. Now when I look back, I think, yes, I did need a lot of grooming to be able to be in front of the camera. But that kind of shattered me. And I remember going home and crying and thinking that, am I really not good enough? But I bounced back to realize that now here's a reason for me to be in front of the camera and to work on myself. And if there is something that I don't have, I should work on it and achieve my dream. मतलब आप अगर गरीब पैदा हुए हो दैट्स योर डेस्टिनी आप उस तरह से पैदा हुए हो पर जिस तरह से आप अपनी लाइफ को बढ़ा सकते हो इट्स टोटली इन योर हैंड्स एंड माय फादर्स स्टोरी टेल्स मी दैट सी अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल थिंक दैट आई कम फ्रॉम अ वेरी रिच फैमिली बट द फैक्ट इज दैट माय फादर एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड ऑफ एज एन ऑटो रिक्शा ड्राइवर ही स्केल्ड सो मच एंड टुडे ऑफ कोर्स ही ड्राइव्स द बेस्ट कार्स In fact, I wrote an article which is called From Auto to Audi. And my mother ensured that all his dreams and ambitions are being supported. She's been like the pillar of strength. I remember we were watching television one day and the 24-hour news channel thing had just started off. And she and I were watching TV and she's like, Kamiya, I think this is what you should be, news anchor. I moved to another TV channel where my main role was not again being in front of the camera. Now I was a producer. Till one day, one of the journalists was supposed to go to Malaysia to cover the F1 Sepang circuit race that was going to happen. And my colleague fell sick. So my boss asked me if I could fill in. I couldn't even pretend to be upset about my sick colleague. I was like, yeah, sure, I'll go for it. I totally loved that experience when I felt like, wow, this is the kind of life some of the journalists are living while I'm confined in my desk job. And this idea struck me that instead of being a news anchor, I want to take up travel journalism as a profession. But just when I quit, I got a call from another competing news channel for a role of a news anchor.
Hi there, you've tuned into Business Day and I'm Kamiya Jani. Let's first take a look at the headlines.
And I worked at ED now for a good 6 years. And I spoke about a lot of business news and stock markets. But in my mind, I still wanted to travel to different places. I was doing a couple of shows at ET Now as well, which were travel related, but they were the priority of the channel was always business news. It was never travel.
Is David Cohen, director of Asian Economics.
You know, when women get married in India, they sort of feel that you belong to a different family and you need to adjust and you need to get accustomed to how that family functions and that becomes your priority. I first thought that I need to have a stable career where I'm able to manage my work and my family together. But was that job my inner calling? No, my inner calling was actually being an independent traveler, experiencing different things, because that's what would make me happy. And I knew the answer long ago, but I continued to do this just to fit in.
Verdict. Corporate lawyer Gopal Jain tells us why.
Well, when you have a young child traveling with you, this is how you end up traveling.
Are you tired, Diana?
No. No. Then you want a good ride on your daddy's shoulder.
I met my husband when I was working as a personal finance writer. And I started getting these anonymous emails on my kamiyajani.com blog that I had. His email ID would read, I can't give it at hotmail.com. Funny emails that he would send. And I think we started dating after 6 months of knowing each other. After seeing each other for another 6 months, we broke up for a year. You know, I was also thinking that if you're seeing somebody, you should get married to him. Which sort of, I guess, got him a bit uncomfortable, and there was a bit of a distance between the two of us. I don't know where I got this feeling, thanks to Bollywood movies or what, I don't know. Then I felt sick, was traveling to Thailand, and I came back and I got swine flu, and he got to know that I've got swine flu. He thought that I'm going to die or something. And again, thanks to Bollywood movies, he thought, oh, this is the moment. And then we got back and he said, yeah, no, I want to marry you this time. I said, sure.
Give party hopping a whole new meaning.
At 18 now, when I became a news anchor, I was also doing these lifestyle shows.
The Weekend Mantra year in special with me, Kamiya Verma. Only on ET Now.
So through this show, I got this opportunity and I really wanted to do this, which was skydiving. And that was the only time it happened in India at Amby Valley. While I was prepping up, I was feeling extremely grateful to God for literally giving me everything that I have ever asked for. And just when we jumped, that experience was so beautiful. I was seeing this beautiful view. I was flying in the sky like a free bird. I felt so thankful towards God. I'm like, wow, God has really blessed me with a good life. When I made a decision that now maybe it's time for me to start my family.
Pregnancy in India is often treated as an illness, something that requires a lot of precaution. But thankfully, in my case, both my doctor and mother-in-law are progressive women who encouraged me to continue working and to travel.
I continued to anchor shows and be in front of the camera till the 28th of August, and 30th of August is when I delivered a baby. I also had morning sickness during pregnancy and I used to do the first show. Fortunately, I had a co-anchor with me. I would feel a bit sick. I would tell my director, I need 2 minutes. I would go out, throw up, come back, act absolutely normal, and then continue the show. I still did go through some emotional turmoil. Whatever life I have been living for myself is going to come to an end, whereas the purpose of my life is only going to be my child's happiness. So till I think the 32nd week, you can travel and you need a doctor's letter that, you know, Kamiya or whoever is the patient is pregnant and is fit to travel. See, I told myself, chalo, then at least you have 9 more months to go. And I got an opportunity to travel to Ireland when I was just 4 months pregnant. Then when I was 7 months pregnant, my husband surprised me with a trip to Istanbul. So after my daughter was born, I was at home for a good 5 months nursing her. My in-laws were very supportive and they would take care of my daughter Ziana when we were both at work.
except for one day when I got an invitation from a beautiful property in Rajasthan, Jaisalmer. I was very, very tempted to visit. Now, my daughter is a year and a half old, and I wasn't sure how I can leave my daughter and go out and travel for, even if it is for 2 days, how do I do that? I was, you know, thinking aloud in my mind whether should I even bring up this question? Is it even okay to ask my mother-in-law? Would she be okay taking care of Ziana for the next 2 days if I happen to travel? And without any hesitation, she said, of course, you can go. I will take care of Ziana. She's been the biggest support system for me. She's never even made me feel guilty. She just thinks that it's her family and the granddaughter is as much hers as much as she's mine. Having people around you who support you through your aspirations, through your dreams, and who are being so supportive towards it only makes the journey a little more easy and comforting.
Having that support back home only made my itch to travel stronger. I needed to hit the road again. I was feeling confined to my air-conditioned new studio. I'd go to work and come back, go to work and come back.
And I remember a point where my trip was scheduled for Dubai the next day, where Dubai Tourism had invited us. My tickets were booked, my visas were done for myself and for the crew. And overnight, I was told that I need to cancel my trip.
How about the rest of the Asia, Serena?
So that's the point when I realized that, you know, when you are an employee of a company, you always have to go by the norms and the rules defined by the company.
Good morning, Megha. Now crew gains for the second day. Tell us more.
And which is when I decided to quit and start something and feeding my soul, which is when I experienced innate happiness of traveling, making videos, putting out online. And that has been the happiest state of my life.
So after 10 years of being in the corporate world, I just wanted to take it easy, do something which is more intimate and personal. But my husband encouraged me to dream big. He said, build a company, build a legacy. He said,
go big or go home. When it started off, Curly Tails was synonym with Kamiya Jani. But I think right now it's beyond me. It's bigger than me. While there is a personal family, Curly Tails again is a different family for me of 20 to 25 people, where I'm trying my best to bring out the best in the team. Mumbai being our base, we have 15 people here in Mumbai office. In Delhi, we have about 3 people working there. And in other places like Pune, Kolkata, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Nagpur, we have a network of freelancers who are working there. Maybe, yes, I am a little more biased towards women. But behind the scenes, both our videographers are males and also our editors, they're all men. But yeah, I think on-air faces so far have been women. It's a very soul-satisfying job that they are doing because a lot of them are so passionate about food and travel. And here's a company that takes two fun things and makes them really serious and is able to generate revenue and also pay off salaries and is also satisfying their souls. So I think it's a great thing.
Welcome to Alila Diva Goa.
How I plan my domestic travel is I drop my daughter to school, which is at 7:45, and I leave immediately for the airport. So I would usually take like a 9:30 a.m. flight and then we are just shooting. And I try to pack in a lot of things in 48 hours. Of course, it gets very tiring for the team, but I know that they are quite understanding of my schedule as well, where I can't be away from my house for really long.
We are baking Christmas cake.
Manna cake. The interesting bit about having been resume work after Ziana was just 5 months old is the fact that she knows that her mama and papa have to go to work every single day. the way she goes through school. Mama and Papa go to office. The best part about this is that how independent she's become. And also the fact that she needs to have a professional career when she grows up, no matter how rich her parents may be or how rich she may be. It's not just about money, it's beyond that. For the women out there, if you ever have to choose between pleasing someone else and pleasing yourself, choose you. Because if you are not happy, you would not exude happiness. Is it okay?
It may sound selfish to always choose yourself, but you need to find the perfect balance where you're not constantly feeling that you are sacrificing or you are giving up on your own desires. Because then you will live a life full of disappointments, and it will come out in one way or the other at some point of your life.
I want to continue to do things that make me happy. I want to wake up feeling excited about what I'm doing. But as long as this is giving me happiness, as long as my body allows me to do this, I think I will do it.
Yeah! Yes, thank you, it was lovely.